Line Road. In 1.3 miles, turn right to merge onto I-75 North.
Bad scenario. he's selling them. They're nowhere.
Evan will find one. Evan will find one. You know he will.
We'll see.
And then you're going to have a decision to make.
Right.
2485. Yeah, I just want to back up the caller, and we'll get to that in a minute. Kyle Mike just tweeted out, Kenny Galladay may do a little today, but it sounds like he'll be very limited at best. No drop ball.
For 21 miles, continue straight.
So they could have two starting rookies at guard. There's a Logan Stenberg would start on the city of Jonah Jackson. Galladay may do a little bit today, so I presume if he's doing a little bit, it's because they haven't given him a full play. I mean, how much practice does Kenny Galladay need? Probably less than most. Again, not ideal, but if he goes today and feels okay, maybe he does a little more tomorrow. Let me ask you a question, though, about that's the update on the Lions and injuries. Let me ask you a question about Caller Dean. He's right, of course. Supply and demand, capitalism. But there's something when the market gets to things like our entertainment, like tickets to games. If there's a big game and the brokers hoard all the tickets, that manifests itself in hatred for the brokers. Like, people get pissed in the world of sports. Do people get pissed when they're trying to pre-order the PS5 and somebody's got bots buying them up for resale? I mean, he's of course right, talking about Caller Dean. That doesn't mean you have to either A, like it, or like the people that are doing it. Because when it comes to hoarding sort of entertainment, it feels dirty. It feels it's bone. I think it's bone.
Well, it is bone, but then I also feel like I'm picking and choosing what I want to believe in capitalism.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
And that's
it's a giant fucking move.
Right, but this is where the hypocrisy comes in.
I went there.
Some things I think, it's fine. You build a better mousetrap and you can make more money off of it. But, people just show you ingenuity. I'll buy a bunch of these and I know that it's a quality product and people are going to want it and it's going to sell out. And, hey, look who's got all the extras. You want some? Over here. And that's capitalism. In some ways, I love it. In some ways, I hate it. And I hate it when it doesn't benefit me. But I'm honest about it, at least.
You're being hypocritical.
In this case, you know, with the PlayStations out there, I mean, it does seem a little weird that there's, I mean, because these people are, like, they're usurping the system of, you know, they're buying like 50 at a time, let's say, okay, or 10 at a time. You know, stores want to do that, but stores have already put in the blood, sweat, and tears of being a business. This is just some kid on the street that got some money together, bought a bunch of them, that he's going to sell them for profit without having to put in the blood, sweat, and tears other businesses.
What's funny is a kid on the street doesn't bother me. It's the grown-ass man that has no interest in the game just trying to take advantage of the kid on the street. That bothers me.
Well, yeah, but the kid on the streets, they got lines. Kids on the street are smart now, too, and they're doing it, so I don't know.
Let's get to the people. 248-539-9797.
Chuck is in the South for Chuck. Welcome to 97 on the ticket. Hey, Chuck.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, man. Hey, Chuck.
So, how you doing? Thank you.
kids don't know how easy they have it. Like back in the day, man, you wanted to go watch, you wanted to see Bon Jovi come to a concert, you had to sleep out ahead of time for outside the record outlet where they sold tickets, and you'd wait in line.
Starting
for
route
the next,
21506, you know, Warman Oak Street.
Open up the doors, you all way through there, and there's some jackass
miles.
In front of you.
Take exit 12 toward
tickets.
Route 5 and Grand River Avenue.
You're like, come on, man, I just want two. I just need two general admission. And then they sell it right in front of you. Did this actually happen, Gator? Is this something that actually happened?
Well, it was a Bon Jovi concert, yeah, back in 1987, I believe. This is where we went to her, and I didn't sleep out for it, but I did skip school. Sorry, Mom. Missed a couple hours of school.
It happened a lot, Brita.
No, it did not happen a lot. Stuck out with a buddy of mine in class that was a year older than me, and we left the premises of the school, got in line 3 hours, I think, or 2 hours before they went on sale. There was a big line. Get all the way up to us, and they say, all that's left are tickets behind the stage. And we were buying tickets for like 10 of us. We're going, so, okay, well, we'll take them. And we literally were walking past after the sale was made, and then they say, and then they go, a second show has just been announced. And we're like, are you kidding me? Second, so we would have had top dog seats for the second show. Instead, we got crappy seats for the first show because of how the system worked. Yeah.
248-539-9797.
Brennan is in West Bloomfield. Brennan, welcome to 97 on the ticket. Hey, Brennan.
Hey, guys.
Hello.
Hey, what's up? What are you doing? How are you doing?
I was doing audits. Now they're sending me to do some kind of move some rocks around in some lady's yard or something. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Were you in the audit list that did Christine just send you a new one?
Yeah, she just sent me a list of like 60 of them or something.
Okay, I just got that list too. Which ones did you do?
I was going by cities because I was in, I did the Wyandottes. I did the Trentons, and I did the Wyandotte Trenton and Riverview.
Okay. Looks like I only got some Wyandotte ones, and then I got East Course and Allen Park and pretty much all of Detroit, so. Okay, no worries, I was just checking because I went to one house that you already went to.
So. Okay.
All right, take
care. Yep, see ya.
3/4 of a mile. Turn left onto Minock Street. Arrived.